All right, everybody. Today, I'm going to do a quick video on how to grow passion fruits from a seed that you can get from the frozen fruit department at Walmart, which is where this particular plant came from. And there it is. It's about 18 months old, and it gave me quite a few flowers. Now, I have to say, in contrast, there's another plant that I planted about the same time, which is right over here. As you can see, it's jumping out of my viburnums in every direction, right here. And it's a much larger plant. And there it goes, right down the side there. And it has not given me a single flower. So this particular one, for some reason, who knows if it's the soil or what it is, but it has given me quite a few flowers over the last 7-8 months. And for some reason, I did not see any fruit. So we're going to help Mother Nature along by providing a little assistance with a brush. Now, you can use this brush to collect the pollen from under the petals and put it on the, what I believe is called the stigma, right there. There's that pollen right there under the stigma. And this should help. Now, you have three of those stigmas. And it's a very beautiful plant. Looks like something from another world. You can also do it another way, where you can grab the pollen little leaflet and put it right underneath. Yeah, like that. So that one, and they only stay open for about a day. I will use the same pollen under this stigma because I took the other ones off earlier for another video. And some of these have already closed. For example, this one here,
it's already
closed, and I don't know if it was pollinated properly, but certainly one can only try. Looks like there's a little fruit in there, which with enough moisture, watering, and fertilization, these should give you some sort of a, there's another real big one over there, some sort of a, there's another one right here. There's actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them right here. So once again, take the pollen and I put it under the stigma, and there's plenty of pollen to go around. Just got to do it well enough. You have to be brisk like the bee and flutter that pollen under these three little stigmas right there, and hope that that will be adequate for a fruit to start developing by morning. And that's the fruit right in there. So these other flowers look like they've already been opened and closed, and they're falling off. But that's how you do the pollination. There's another one in here. Right there, you take the pollen underneath the stigma, you rub it under there, and hope that you've done an adequate enough job where Mother Nature was unable to do her job. And that's it. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for other great videos from Green Thumb Chronicles. Have a great day.